Hey, brothers and sisters, this is Brother Patrick here in the Philippines. You know, every day and everything, there's always bittersweetness in our lives as long as we're on this earth. So today, it's April the 12th, and it is the birthday of Joshua, who's the namesake of our ministry, Joshua's ministry, but really also Joshua from the Bible. Our ministry is named after my stepson Joshua, who died in 2012. So what Filipinos normally do is they have a death anniversary celebration, or what do you call it? They get together and eat, like when your mom dies, your dad dies, or your relative, you know, whatever. Every year you will have like a meal on the day of their death. But what we decided to do was, because of Joshua was a child, that we would do it on his birthday. So it's a blessing in the fact that I have a sister-in-law who was finally able to finish college because she had taken a year off twice because she has two children. She was able to finish as a pharmacist, so thank the Lord for that. She'll be taking her board exam. I should pray for her. Her name is Lovely. She will pass her board exam to become a, get her license as a pharmacist. I think she takes a test next month. I have one of my original orphans just graduated also yesterday from nursing school. Her name is Diana, one of the original batch of orphans that I had when I first started coming to the Philippines. She was not even in high school, and I got a hold of her. She was the first orphan that I got, and I sent her to a better high school than the where she lived in the middle of nowhere, to a first-class high school, and then I sent her to a good college. You know, I would just throw it out there that all that I've done for the Lord, for the ministry, until we started Joshua's ministry and at the end of August, or really, let's just say September, beginning of September 2012, was out of my own money, brothers and sisters, out of my own savings, my own finances. So I thank the Lord, and I believe that all the sowing that I did in the past, you know, Joshua's ministry is reaping that now. You do reap what you sow. I should do a video. I mentioned it before in the past, in my own personal testimony, you know, of that the Lord provided a way for me to have my own money to come here to the Philippines in 2007 and live. And I came 2005, 2006 for the summer each year. And then I was able to move here full-time in 2007, as the Lord provided. But part of that was the fact that I tithed, and then I even gave offerings beyond my tithes, and gave and gave and gave and gave and gave. And the natural fruit of that was yesterday, as I mentioned, the first orphan that I ever sponsored. She was in the 8th grade, or in the Philippines, they only go to 10th grade. So she was actually in the 6th grade, last year of elementary school. When I got a hold of Diana, and the Lord led me to bring her to a bigger, from the middle of nowhere to a town, not a big city, but say a town of 50,000 people, and send her to high school, and then to a big city here at Davao to go to college. And thank the Lord for that. So the natural fruit of this first orphan is now she's graduated from nursing school, and by the grace of God, you know, she's a Christian. She will meet and marry, you know, a Christian man, maybe an American, you know, pastor or missionary or whatever, American businessman or whatever, where she can turn around, you know, and do things for the Lord here, build orphanages or do medical missions. She's a nurse. Maybe she'll marry a doctor or another nurse, and then they could do medical missions and things like that. Who knows what the Lord would have planned? So I thank the Lord for that. I'm playing the music in the background because I will title this, you know, A Prayer for Those Who Ask. So I always play music on the videos that I pray, not on my teaching or preaching videos. Because just like Elisha, when the king of Israel and the king of Judah asked him for some prophetic word from the Lord, and he had him dig these ditches and then it filled with water and all this. It's a really interesting story, as a matter of fact. But the point of that story I would bring up right now is the fact that Elisha said, bring me a musician, someone to play worship music to the Lord, and then I can hear from the Lord better. And that is truly, very truly true. that even though we can hear from the Lord anytime, even like myself, as I, by the grace of God, have been over the last 14 years growing in my ministry and calling from the Lord, is I would minister to people and just be talking to them about the Lord without any music. Then the Holy Spirit would flow as I'm speaking of the Word of God. But absent from that, when you just kick off out of nowhere, you know, without, you know, just in your flesh and then to transition to the Spirit. That's why I always, brothers and sisters, if you go to churches, like I actually visited Rick Joyner's group. I usually don't like to mention names, but I went down there because it's in Charlotte at the old Heritage USA of Jim and Tammy Baker. I went down there just to check it out, and I'd read this book, and I think it's a good book. It's kind of like Pilgrim's Progress, this Final Quest. I think it's an excellent book. But just like almost every church I've been to, any China church, you talk about people supposed to be Spirit-filled to get up there and start flowing under the anointing. Almost every church, in the churches I preached in, big churches I preached in the States and in the Philippines, the people that's getting ready to preach, they'll be in the back laughing and joking and talking about their golf game, you know, and carrying on some carnal conversation. And then they walk out on stage, and then they're going to flow in the Spirit of God. You can do that some, but for me, I mean, you know, for me, I always want to praise and worship and get a hold of the Lord before I will preach, if I have the opportunity. You never know when you may spontaneously be in a situation where you need to start ministering to people. Of course, I've done that plenty of times also. But you know, like I say, when I go to these churches, it grieved me a lot when I saw these preachers. I've seen it dozens of times where they're all in the flesh and then boom, they step on stage and then they're preaching without really even spending any time in prayer and worship. The secret to the anointing is our time we spend in prayer and worship with the Lord, reading His Word, and then of course praying and worshiping Him in the secret place of the Most High, Psalm 91 verse 1. But it is true, you can, after years of ministry, you can, you know, the Holy Spirit can come on you suddenly. And if you guys have been watching my videos, maybe you've seen it in my videos where the Holy Spirit kind of came on me after I started speaking. But I'd pray, I usually pray in advance almost 100% of the time, unless it was, I had to hurry up and do the video. But, you know, as I was just thinking too of when I was in the States and I went there in August, and I visited a sister's house, and we made a video there. And, you know, when we started making the video, the Holy Spirit did come on me, and I hadn't prayed in advance. And so that was a time when it happened to me. And it does through practice. But the whole conversation, everything we had was about the Lord anyway. We were talking about the Lord, not necessarily cardinal issues. Anyway, brothers and sisters, always, you know me, it's already 8 minutes. I haven't prayed for anybody yet. You know, let's go, guys. Let's pray for some people. I cut it off last time because I just had run out of steam. And I want to try to push through the rest of these names. I've got lots of new names that I've... There's people asking. I'm not really hardly going to give anybody a private word. There is a few people who the Lord led me, who asked me who I'm giving a private word to and not in the video. But I'm not going to do that for anybody and everybody, only the people that need to ask me, you know. So people who want a word for their friend of a friend of a friend who's not even a Christian, unless the Lord leads me to do that, I'm not going to do that. If I give someone a word, people need to ask me themselves for a word, and then it will be in a video, unless the Lord leads me different. You know, if the Lord give me a word probably that's like, you know, some private matter with someone that's probably not, you know, needs to be, it's not an exhortation, maybe it's a rebuke or whatnot, something like that, I'll probably do it more in a in a private message, if you can, you know what I'm saying. So it's just common sense also that some things we don't put out in public, even though we don't know the name, as far as the Lord leads. I want to go to Barb. I have this Barb here, do not have a last initial. And I ask you guys to come in agreement with me, those of you who are prayer warriors, to agree with me to pray for Sister Barb. In Jesus' name. Father, right now we come in agreement and we pray for Sister Barb in Jesus' name. Hallelujah. Hallelujah, Lord. Halalabusa kana Yahweh. Hakumasima Yahweh. Harabusa ma Yahweh. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Glory to your holy name, Lord Jesus. Hallelujah. 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 You know, I just see this like one of those, the clothes like they wore, like the clothes that Jesus wore when he walked the earth. I keep seeing that, the garment that the Lord would wear, or those people wore in those days, like a robe, or a, what do you call it, like a toga looking, or robe, or whatever you call it, the garment that the, like what Jesus wears in the movies and stuff, you see, I see that outfit, or you know, that's robe, and then I see a sheep, Sister Barb. I see a sheep, and then I see that robe, but it's not necessarily the Lord, but like the clothes that the Lord would wear. So I ask you guys to pray for Sister Barb for the meaning. I tried to do Sister Barb a word on the last video, and I was having a hard time getting a word for her. It's like the second or third time I tried to pray for her. So I ask you guys to pray for her, Sister Barb, for further understanding on that. Kendra G. Kendra G. We pray in agreement right now, Father, in Jesus' name, for Sister Kendra G. Hallelujah, Lord. We ask for your blessings, Lord God. Hallelujah. Blessings and not cursings. The Lord is telling me to tell you, Kendra G, blessings and not cursings. So the Lord wants you to bless and not curse. Bless and not curse, Kendra G, in Jesus' name. Hallelujah. Ruth B. Ruth and Boaz. Hallelujah, Father, we give you the praise and glory in the name of Jesus. We pray for Ruth B. Hallelujah, Lord, we come in agreement right now. Hallelujah. 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 And I hear the word house. House. I don't know if you're trying to buy a house, you're praying about a house, or but the Lord has given me the word house. Victory in the house. Victory for the house or in the house. I don't know if that means, you know, like your relatives will be saved, or the Lord's talking about literally, you'll, you know, maybe you're trying to buy a house or sell a house. So it's victory in the house for you, Ruth B, in Jesus' name. Hallelujah. The first video I prayed for these people, the one that I took down and then I made it public again, that I have the link to on the last video, word for those who asked, number 10. I think I prayed for these same people I'm praying for now, but I'm redoing it because it was just, I was just running out of steam and couldn't continue to flow. Now I pray for Hannah. Hannah, in the name of Jesus, in California. Hannah in California, I do believe, who's pregnant. Right now, Father, in the name of Jesus, I pray. We pray. We come in agreement and pray for Sister Hannah. We pray the blessings for her baby in Jesus' name. We pray for a spirit of wisdom to be upon her and reverence for sacred things. Hallelujah. And the Lord is telling me that, you know, the spirit of wisdom and reverence for sacred things to be upon you in Jesus' name. Hallelujah, for a pregnancy is a sacred thing with the Lord. All pregnancies is a sacred thing with the Lord. For this is the creative work of the Lord God Almighty in people. That's why the devil loves abortions. That's why these Luciferians and the Illuminati, they love abortions. Because a pregnancy is a sacred thing to our Lord and our God, as he would knit us in our womb of our mother. Hallelujah. Created in his image. Hallelujah, that we are the superior creation. All those who exalt animals to be equal with men, spend their time, energy, and money promoting animal rights, to exalt animals to be equal with humans is an abomination and a blaspheme to the very words of the Most High God. When he created them, created he him, them in his own image. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. For man is created in the image of God. Sister Hannah, have a reverence or for sacred things. Hallelujah, in Jesus' name. And Lord, we give you wisdom in this area, what I just talked about. Right now, I pray for Carrie. We come in agreement to pray for Carrie B. C-A-R-I, Carrie B. Father, right now, in the name of Jesus, right now, Lord, let the head be lifted up, the Lord says. Hallelujah. Lift up your head. Straighten the feeble knees. It's from Hebrews in there. I can't remember the chapter where it says, you know, straighten the feeble knees. You know, walk straight. Walk upright. Be strengthened in your walk with the Lord in Jesus' name. Lift up your head. Lift up thine head, says the Lord. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Let the redeemed of the Lord say so. Carrie B. All of that being said, it seems like maybe that it's, you know, you have depression or something along those lines, or you're, you know, need to walk, you know, straight in your walk with the Lord. I just pray right now for, we come in agreement and pray for you, Sister Carrie B., for healing, for, you know, spirit of heaviness to be lifted off of you, and the Lord would give you a garment of praise for the spirit of heaviness, Isaiah chapter 61. And I'm sorry, I cannot remember the text in Hebrews where it talks about straighten the feeble knees. You can Google this stuff. Nowadays with Google, you can just Google straighten the feeble knees and go look it up. It's in Hebrews and Isaiah 61. The Lord would give you a garment of praise for a spirit of heaviness, Sister Carrie B. Okay, Lucy. Lucy C. Father, right now in the name of Jesus, we pray for Lucy C. Lord, we declare your victory right now in Jesus' name. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. I hear the word life. Let there be life in Jesus' name. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Life. Hallelujah. Life in Jesus' name. I speak life. Hallelujah. The Lord has given me a word that's a Spanish word. I don't know the meaning. Fandango. I think that's a dance. I don't know, Sister Lucy. See, you know, I don't speak Spanish. Many Filipino words are Spanish, and that's not one that I know of. Hallelujah, Father, we give you the praise and glory as I pray for Sister. We come in agreement, Lord, and pray for Sister Lucy. See, we lift her up to you, Father, right now in Jesus' name. And the Lord has told me to fandango. It's like a dance or something. And life. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Sister Lucy, see, you know, the word of God says in James that life is but a vapor, you know, and then it fades away. You know, we just have we're a wave tossed in the ocean. We only have a season on this earth. But the world would say, like the Epicureans, I believe it is, it said, you know, eat and drink for tomorrow we die. That's also in the Bible, in the book of Acts. Paul talks about that. But for us Christians, you know, today we serve the Lord and we praise the Lord and we enjoy our lives because, you know, our life is but a moment on this earth. And we do all we can to bring glory to the Lord and worship Him and praise Him and rejoice forevermore in Christ Jesus. Hallelujah. Rejoice forevermore. That's another Bible verse the Lord is telling me to tell you, pray without ceasing. Rejoice forevermore. I believe that is 1 Thessalonians chapter 5. In light of the fact that the rapture is soon, we should rejoice forevermore and pray without ceasing. 1 Thessalonians chapter 5, Sister Lucy C. is another text. Hallelujah. Pauline G. We pray for Sister Pauline G. in Jesus' name. Hallelujah. And the Lord is just talking to me about the, you know, like the wine dregs. Dregs is like what's on the bottom of a wine barrel, you know, that falls to the bottom of the wine barrel. In the Bible, it talks about that, you know, and I can't remember even, it's been a while since I've looked at that. Like on the bottom of the wine barrel, the dregs. And that's the word the Lord just gave me. You can Google that, look that up, Sister Pauline G. Father, right now, in the name of Jesus, we continue to pray for Sister Pauline G., Lord. And I hear circuit breaker, circuit breaker. Now, a circuit breaker can literally be the circuit breaker, you know, for your electrical stuff in your house. Sometimes the Lord gives me literal stuff, and I, you know, and then sometimes it's spiritual and or both. So circuit breaker would be like, spiritually speaking, I would say a circuit breaker is like you get too much pressure on you and then you cut off, you know. You're overloaded with stress or something like that. We just pray for you, Pauline G., for your victory in Jesus' name. And we pray right now for the Lord to give you His peace, His comfort right now. Remove the stress and overload in your life, or even if it's in your house, that whatever needs to be fixed or repaired, you would have the wisdom, the guidance, and the favor to have it all corrected in Jesus' name. Jean D. G-E-N-E-D. We pray right now for Jean D. in the name of Jesus Christ, the Son of the living God. I hear the word, again, it's pretty close, eczema and exhume. I'm sorry. I'm trying to flow in this. Father, in the name of Jesus, I guess it's eczema would be what I would be hearing. Father, we give you the praise and the glory, Lord. I just pray. We come in agreement and pray for Gene D right now in the name of Jesus Christ. And it's eczema. I hear the word eczema, skin rash, skin disease. Father, right now we declare for healing right now and victory for Gene D over eczema in Jesus' name. Right now, for him or their family member or themselves, we pray right now for victory right now over eczema in Jesus' name. Hallelujah, Father, we give you the praise. Speak right now to victory right now. And I see gold. I mean, sometimes gold is literally, you know, financial blessing. Or, you know, I guess it's financial blessing or also about, you know, the kingdom of the Lord. It's, you know, gold. And I see gold. Gene D, I see gold in Jesus' name. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. We just declare victory right now. Victory for Gene D. Hallelujah, Lord. Let your spirit flow, Lord. Father, I just release, Lord, the anointing that's in me upon your people, Father. All the people I prayed for so far, Lord. And the people I'm about to pray for, Lord, as I would continue as you would let me, Lord, and flow, Lord, Father, in Jesus' name, Lord. Your Holy Spirit flow upon your people, Father, in Jesus' name, right now, Lord. I just release, Lord God, that spirit of wisdom upon your people, Lord. Hallelujah, Lord. I just release a spirit of wisdom upon your people right now in Jesus' name. Hallelujah. I speak wisdom. Rivers of living water. Rivers of wisdom in Jesus' name. Hallelujah, Lord. Hallelujah. Speak right now that there is light at the end of the tunnel. There is light at the end of the tunnel. Hallelujah. Those who have been in darkness shall see a great light. Hallelujah. And that prophecy was fulfilled one time already when the Lord Jesus Christ was seen in the Decapolis, they call it. The regions of Tyre and Sidon or whatever around the Sea of Galilee. And the great light was seen. That was the Messiah when he walked the earth, the Lord Jesus Christ. Hallelujah. Phil K. Father, right now we come in agreement and pray for Phil K. Lord, we speak your victory right now in Jesus' name. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. I just keep hearing from the Lord about this light, you know, the light at the end of the tunnel. I guess that's for you, Phil K. Also, specifically. For the light of the world shines into darkness, and the darkness comprehendeth it not. Hallelujah. The Lord Jesus is the light of the world, Phil K, and he commands us to be salt and light. You know, he said a city on a hill cannot be hidden. Nobody lights a candle and puts it under a basket. So let your light so shine before men that they would see your good works and glorify your Father who is in heaven. Sharon B. Right now, Father, in the name of Jesus, we come in agreement and pray for Sister Sharon B. I hear the word deluxe or luxury, deluxe. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Luxury, Father, we declare your victory right now in Jesus' name. Hallelujah. I just hear the Lord saying, you know, like the lap of luxury for you, Sister Sharon B. And whatever that means specifically to you, maybe something you're prayer requesting about. Asking about, the Lord loves to give good gifts to those who ask, it says. In the Word of God. There's one time, it's in Matthew and in Luke chapter 11. And in the Matthew version of that text, it says he loves to give good gifts to those who ask. And I'm not a, you know, this, you got your prosperity gospel stuff. But God does bless his children. There's peace. He can bless us with peace, with joy, with happiness, even finances, whatever it is. The Lord loves to give good gifts to those who ask. He loves to bless his children, just like we love to bless our children. You know, we want to give them chocolates, but not too much to make them sick, to ruin their dinner. But we give them chocolates. We give them ice cream. We take them to the vacation. We take them to the beach if we got money. We, you know, whatever. We give them good gifts. And the Lord loves to give us good gifts. that's not, you know, each child can handle different levels of without ruining them, spoiling them to death, right? Sharon B., Lord is telling me about the lap of luxury and deluxe and luxury for you. Sister Sharon B., praise God. Martha F. from K., a city, Kville. That's not Kville. It's actually another city. I'm thinking of another city that's nearby. This is a city in North Carolina that starts with a K. And it's, I know this place. My uncle, as a matter of fact, lives in this place. And he was a pastor. My uncle had a heart attack. He lives in the same place, the same town. Let's pray for Martha F. in Jesus' name. I don't know her, but she lives just maybe 30 minutes from where I'm from. And Father, right now we pray for Sister Martha F. in Jesus' name, Lord. Hallelujah. Father, we just pray right now for victory, victory, victory in the name of Jesus Christ, the Son of the living God. Hallelujah. Father, we pray for Martha F. in Jesus' name. Hallelujah, hallelujah. And I just hear the Lord saying, don't look a gift horse in the mouth. Don't look a gift horse in the mouth. So the meaning of that, of course, in that expression is as if someone's giving, you know, don't bite the hand that feeds you. I guess it's kind of similar. Not exactly the same, but, you know, don't, get mad or reject, that's something that's a gift to you. Now, that may mean that it can mean a literal gift that someone's giving you something and you're getting mad at them. Or it can also mean that there's someone, like the Lord removes someone out of your life that's a good thing, and then you don't like that either. It's something, and I believe that's what it is, Sister Martha. It's more along the line that God did something for you that is good, like remove someone out of your life or something like that, and then you're not receiving it as a good thing. Sister Martha F. Now Corey, let's pray for Corey in Florida. Hallelujah, Father, right now in the name of Jesus Christ, we pray for Corey in Florida right now. He's just moving there. Hallelujah. I remember now he did message me and told me that he was looking to move to Florida. And like I say, if I know the people, I will mention that I do. 99% of the people, I don't know them or anything about them. So right now we pray for Corey in Florida right now. Hallelujah, that he's just going to move there. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Father, we speak your blessings. Hallelujah, and your wisdom and your guidance right now. Father, we pray for Brother Corey. Hallelujah, Lord God. Hallelujah. We just declare your victory right now. Victory, 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 victory in Jesus' name. Hallelujah. Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. I just speak a wind. I just hear the word wind, Brother Corey. Wind in Jesus' name. W-I-N-D. Wind. Hallelujah. Now a wind can be the Holy Spirit or a wind can be the natural wind. And Father, we give you the praise and the glory in the name of Jesus Christ. Hallelujah. And the Lord, I hear the word is, there's times that there's a wind at our back and windward. And there's a time when the wind is in our face. And I pray right now, Brother Corey, that the wind be at thy back. Hallelujah. That you have smooth sailing. You know, the terms that the Lord has given me is about sailing, because I heard, you know, wind and then windward, like a windward islands or windward, I guess. I've never sailed, but I've heard some of these terms a little bit. That's like a, you know, also sailing. And then I just, as I just said, what I just said was another sailing term. I guess I said sailing, whatever I just said. So those things that the Lord has given me has got about sailing, like a sailboat or going sailing. Brother Corey, the Lord has given me these terms in reference to sailing. Father, right now, in the name of Jesus Christ, Father, we give you the praise and the glory. Hallelujah. Hallelujah, Lord. I had stopped and explained, and then I lost the flow of what I was saying, but Lord, we ask for your blessings on Brother Corey right now and his family in Jesus' name. Hallelujah. And then the Lord had just spoke to me about sailing. Hallelujah. Father, we give you the praise and the glory in the name of Jesus Christ, Lord. We honor you. We praise you, Father, in Jesus' name. Hallelujah. We praise you, Father, in Jesus' name. Hallelujah. Well, I guess my music tried to dial me. You know, what can you do, brothers and sisters? I'm going to continue with this video, and I want you guys to begin to pray for Brother Leo. I believe that's Leopold. And let's pray for Brother Leopold. And in Jesus' name, we're going to pray for Brother Leopold. I just want to play, find some music to play as the Lord would lead me in Jesus' name. Hallelujah, Lord, we praise you. We praise your name, Lord God. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Father, we praise you in Jesus' name. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. We're going to praise you right now, Father. And I've got lots of names. And I just want to tell you guys this because I know a little bit of something about Brother Leopold. Because he's publicly put comments on my videos about this. Now, Brother Leopold, his name is Leopoldo, maybe, I think it is. I'm sorry, brother, but he lives in San Francisco, California. He has HIV. And he's trying to come out of the homosexual lifestyle. And I've been praying for him. And I've talked with him here and there over the last year or two, I guess, for a long time. And he has not been able to break free from homosexuality. And of course, he's got AIDS. And he's got, you know, he has lots of issues with that. And his family and all this. And he's got, you know, it's like there's no Christians. They're all the people around him are bad or, you know, evil people. And he's really in like a personal, like a hell on earth. And he desires, you know, to walk with the Lord. And he's just in such a bad place. And there's, you know, after 14 years in the ministry, I mean, I've been able to help lots of people. But sometimes there's things that, you know, that's just over your pay grade. I mean, this is something that only the Lord can do. I mean, this is a big one, you know. And that's why I want you guys to help me pray for Brother, Leo, use the name Leo. It's easier to say. And let's just pray for him right now in Jesus' name. Hallelujah. There's another Leo too. So this guy's, I think it's Leopoldo is a way of saying. I have another Leo also. So I have two, a Leo L. I don't want to confuse them. Let's just pray for this brother Leopoldo right now in Jesus' name. Hallelujah. Father, we just pray for him right now in the name of Jesus Christ. Lord, we speak for his deliverance from homosexuality, Lord. We ask for you, Lord, to make a way that he can get away from these evil people, Lord, and he can have peace and he can have an opportunity to clear his mind and be set free. And, Lord, give him the grace, Lord, to repent, Lord God. Father, we come in agreement and pray for him to have the spirit of prayer and supplication to be on him. Spirit of grace, spirit of deliverance, Lord God. No man can come to you unless the Father draws them, Lord. Lord, we ask you to heal him of AIDS, Lord. We ask you to deliver him from this pit, Lord God. Lord, help him, Lord. Help him, Lord. Help him, Lord. Because he's been double-minded. The Lord is just saying for me to tell you, brother, assuming you say you're a Christian, that you have been double-minded. That's from James. As you know, somebody that's double-minded this is creating confusion. Your double-mindedness is creating confusion, says the Lord. Choose this day whom you will serve. The Lord or the flesh. And I plead with you, brother, and I ask everyone to pray for you that the Lord would strengthen you. I know. I mean, I've never been, thank God I've never been homosexual, never had the desire to be homosexual. Thank the Lord. But, you know, all people have sin, whatever it may be. We have different desires and sin, even if it's for, even heterosexual sex outside of marriage and all that, you know, so okay, adultery, fornication, all that, whatever. Drugs, alcohol, whatever is our temptations that are our own personal weaknesses. You know, it's only by the power of God that we can overcome, brother. And that's why we're going to pray for you that the Lord will do a miracle and take these desires away from you. and deliver you. But the Lord is saying that you are double-minded. Brother, you must commit. Now, this is an example of something that is not necessarily my intention to make public. But this brother's been talking to me public about it, and the Lord just came upon me to talk about it. The Lord is saying you've been double-minded. And you have got to set your heart's desire toward the things of God, and God will strengthen you. You have to choose whom you will serve, brother. You can't be caught in betwixt, as they say. In between the world, the flesh, and the devil, and God. You must choose. All right, let's switch gears here. I've got a Leo L. Leo L. Let's pray for Leo L. Not to be confused with the one I just prayed for. It's two different ones. I've got really back to back here. We pray for Leo L. right now in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah, we give you the glory, Lord God. We pray for Leo L. And I just hear life, liberty, and the pursuit of happiness. Hallelujah, from the Declaration of Independence. Hallelujah. Father, we give you the praise and the glory right now. Hallelujah. And I hear the word despot. Despot, the, you know, like a dictator or a king. Or so, and then that first phrase I gave, it leads me to think that you're, you know, of a libertarian mindset. That you know you're a truther and a birther and all that kind of stuff. And there's lots of truth to those movements. And I believe that's where your calling is, or the things that the Lord would have you involved with is, you know, about the, you know, supporting the Constitution and be involved in the, you know, with those rights are God, as it tells us in there, we are endowed by our Creator with certain inalienable rights, some of which are life, liberty, and the pursuit of happiness. And that's the word that the Lord gave me, and then I mentioned about despot. And so it is true, our government is like becoming a despot government and a dictatorship and all of these kind of things. And, you know, that's where your ministry is. Your calling is to be involved in that, to cry for liberty, because it comes from our Creator. Remember that, Brother Leo, that we are endowed by our Creator with certain inalienable rights. So the authority of the government comes from God to the people, and then we loan it to the government as our servants. The government has done away with God, and they've done away the fact that it's by the people, for the people, and to the people. That the government is in subjection to the people, not the people in subjection to the government. So that is a Christian idea and values, that we are endowed by our Creator with these inalienable rights. And that's your ministry, and that's your area, Brother Leo. I confirm that to you in Jesus' name. You know, the Christian truth movement, the Christian liberty movement, you know, the revolution. You don't hear about it too much, and I haven't really studied it that much myself, just a little bit. But there were many preachers who were involved in the Revolutionary War period and were used by God to help encourage and support the American Revolutionary people. It wasn't all just about the Masons and stuff. Okay, we're at 40 minutes, brothers and sisters. I don't know. Let's see. I guess I should do a separate video. Let's go with Deborah A. Let's try to do until the Lord gives me anything different. Right now, I'll pray for Deborah A. In Jesus' name, hallelujah, we come in agreement. Pray for Deborah A. Hallelujah, Lord God, we give you the praise and glory. And I hear salt. I hear salt and light. And that's probably the number one word I've been getting for people. We are to be salt and light in this world. We're supposed to set the example and demonstrate Christ to the non-believer, to the world. Deborah, and if salt has lost its savor, what good is it, Jesus said, except to be thrown in the dunghill? May the Lord fill you with the savor of His holiness and His righteousness and His good news, the gospel message. Excuse me, Deborah A. May you walk in the light of the Lord, the light that the Lord has given you. To whom much is given, much is required, Deborah A. May you walk in the light that the Lord has given you. And that's more a direct word from the Lord. Nathan. I remember Nathan messaged me, and I believe he's the one that asked me if the Lord could give me my last name. The Lord will give what we need to hear. for anybody. The Lord gives us what we need to hear. Sometimes He gives people's names, but not, you know, it's like, whatever. The Lord gives us what we need to hear, not what we want to hear, is what I'm saying. We can ask for something, but what we hear from the Lord is what we really need to hear. It's like Nicodemus. He came to Jesus and said, you know, we know you, in John chapter 3, we know you came from God because no one else can do the miracles you did except they came from God. Did Jesus say, yeah, you're right, Nicodemus? No. He said what Nicodemus needed to hear, because Nicodemus was somebody. He had a birthright as an Israelite. He had a birthright because he was, you know, this hoity-toity family there, and because of his status of his family, he was on the Sanhedrin. He was a somebody in Israel by his natural birth. And Jesus said to him, cut right to the heart of Nicodemus's problem, and said, except a man be born again, he cannot enter the kingdom of heaven. You know, then he went on to say how, you know, it's we're born not from the will of man and all, or the flesh and all that, but by the will of God. So the Lord tells us what we need to hear. Brother Nathan, let's come in agreement and pray for Brother Nathan in Jesus' name. Father, right now we come in agreement. We pray for Brother Nathan, and we speak your mercy and your blessings upon Brother Nathan in Jesus' name. Hallelujah. Father, we give you the praise and the glory right now. Hallelujah, Father, in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. And I know that there is a rift. There is a rift between Brother Nathan and maybe it's myself or the Lord. I don't know, but I hear the word rift. Hallelujah, Father, we give you the praise and glory in Jesus' name. Father, we exalt your holy name. Hallelujah, Lord, we just pray for Brother Nathan, that this rift would be conquered, and that Nathan would come back and be free from any misdirection, misguidance, misleading that he has experienced in the past. And I guess that's what the Lord is saying, Brother Nathan. Sometimes he speaks, tonight he keeps speaking to me like that. He's been giving me these words, and then so rift, and then I heard misguided and all that. So someone is, you know, put you through some teaching in a rift between you and the Lord and away from the true gospel, and misguided you in some way. And I praise God. And the Lord is, I feel the joy of the Lord because from the Lord himself, because you're seeking, you're a truth seeker. Brother Nathan, you are a truth seeker, and to come back to the light of the gospel and understand the gospel properly by the grace of God. And I decree and declare right now, brother, that let there be light as you continue to seek truth, as you continue to seek wisdom. For the word of God says, he who lacks wisdom, let him ask. And the Lord loves to give it liberally and abradeth it not. In James chapter 1, the Lord will release his wisdom upon you as you seek him and ask for it, Brother Nathan. And this rift, this misdirection, this misguidance will be, you know, corrected. And it's being corrected by the Most High God, by His Spirit, and by His Word. Praise God Almighty, Brother Nathan, that my sheep know my voice, the Lord said, and they will answer not to another. And the Lord is calling you by His own name, hallelujah, to deliver you from the snare of the fowler, that's, you know, from the trap of the enemy, set you free. Those whom the Son has set free are free indeed, Brother Nathan. Hallelujah. And then for you also, there's that light at the end of the tunnel. There's that moment when you break forth into the things you've been seeking from God, you break forth in Jesus' name. Hallelujah. I hear the word spirit of lust. I hear the word spirit of lust. And I decree and declare right now, we come in agreement and speak deliverance and healing and set free from the spirit of lust, Brother Nathan. The Lord would set you free from the spirit of lust in Jesus' name. Hallelujah, in Jesus' name. That's the tunnel that you've been going through, that darkness, that you would spring forth speedily from the spirit of lust in Jesus' name. Seek the Lord. Seek Him. Brother Nathan, I ask you to come in agreement with us. We're praying and believing for your total victory, healing, deliverance, and all things be new. Behold, when someone gets saved, it says that the old things have passed away. Behold, all things become new. You're a new creature in Christ. Let the redeemed of the Lord say so. Those whom the Lord has set free are free indeed. Now, Brother Nathan, the Lord has set you free. Hallelujah. He's led captivity captive. Hallelujah. That you were once lost in sin. You were once a captive. But the Lord has set you free by his blood, by his spirit, by his word, not by might or power, but by my spirit, saith the Lord. Let the redeemed of the Lord say so, Brother Nathan. Hallelujah, hallelujah. I say there's life. Let there be life in Jesus' name. Victory in Jesus' name. Hallelujah. Praise God. Praise God. That Nathan is a son of God. As it tells us in John chapter 1. To those who believe on his name, the Lord Jesus Christ, to them he gave power to become the sons of God. Behold, here comes one as a son of God, Nathan. God calls those things and speaks those things. I prophesy that and know it's already true and declare it right now in Jesus' name. Nathan, you are a son of God. Here comes a son of God. Hallelujah. Glory to the Most High God. Hallelujah. Victory. Victory in Jesus' name. Hallelujah. Father, we honor you. We praise you in Jesus' name. Hallelujah. Brothers and sisters, I better stop there. And there's lots of people that wanted to... Like I said, there's a few people who I will give a private message to. I need to do that while I'm in the middle of this. God bless you guys. God bless all you guys. Hey, I forgot what I was going to... There's lots of things I wanted to ask you to update you guys about the ministry. Anyway... we're going to start doing a radio show. It'll be Brother Sid and myself. But I think we're going to start with a live chat next Friday night at 10 o'clock Eastern Standard Time. I'm going to get back. I don't know how effective we can do with the chat. If we can, you know, the chat on the website, Church of Firstborn. I ask you guys to go there, sign up for the chat. Message me if you think it's a good idea, if you're going to be on there. If we do it every Friday night, 10 o'clock Eastern Standard Time, 10 a.m. here in the Philippines. Then when I get to the States, we'll start the radio show with it, like blog talk radio or something. Ask you guys to let me know if you think it's a good idea, or maybe I can do the radio show from here. Please let me know, and any ideas you have about it. God bless.